Hey guys, welcome back. Today we've got a Mastertemp heater, and as you can hear in the background, it is just popping and cracking. Sounds like the noise is coming from here. Let me show you how to fix it. First thing, take off the side panel so you can access the manifold. I will disconnect the wires from all the sensors. The high limit, the low limit, the AGS, the temperature sensor, the pressure switch, all those, we'll just take them all loose. Now, I actually prefer to use an impact on this. Sometimes they'll be seized up, and if you twist them loose by hand, sometimes they'll break. So the impact ensures that they come out without any problem. Not a necessity, but just I've found it works a bit better. Use a wrench, loosen up the collars. Now, most of the heaters have enough play where you can slide them back just a little. You are going to need just a little room to get that manifold loose. Helps me take all the screws out. Duh. Okay, get that out. Let me show you how to take it apart. It doesn't look like it comes apart, but you can see there's a seam right along the edge. Just get you a flat tip screwdriver and gently work it around. You will have to remove the temperature sensor, temperature probe rather, because it sticks out into the cavity there, and it'll hang up. So just get a screwdriver, kind of pop it out. Take your time with it. You really don't want to break that housing. As you can see here in just a second, when I finally get this thing open, there was a ball of calcium. Yeah, didn't think much of it at first, except there was a bunch of calcium all inside this manifold, but it was a pretty good wad. And for a minute I thought that's got to be the problem. You could just heard it rattling and popping in there. But typically when we have a heater that rattles and pops and shakes, the problem is actually this bypass valve, which is what I'm working on getting out. So that's your spring, that's your thermal fuse or thermal regulator. This piece right here. Now actually I was kind of surprised to see it all intact. There you go. But it looks like it's actually working like it's supposed to. It's all one piece. So I went ahead and put it back together. Cleaned all the calcium out of it. I did decide to go ahead and replace that spring, as you'll see here in a second. Get all that old calcium out of there, keep it from clogging up again. And you'll see in just a minute that something else was actually the problem. Now this, I'm gonna go ahead and put a new thermal regulator on it. This is what controls the flow of water through the heater. It goes on the end of the spring. And as that thing heats up, it allows more water to pass through the manifold. As it's cool, it slows the water down going through there, so gives it more time to heat. So since I had it apart and the other one was covered in calcium, this is a new one here, nice and pretty, and you can see the spring assembly on the bypass where it's in place like it's supposed to be. Okay, we'll get her put back together. Just gonna reassemble it the way you took it apart. Not much to it. There is two slots in that in the manifold, so you can't really put it together wrong. Gonna go ahead and lube this gasket up, just so it all goes back together easy or easy enough. Now, you don't see this in the video because I didn't record it, but after I got this put back together, I went ahead and reinstalled it on the heater, but it still was cracking and popping, which did not make any sense. I took it apart a second time and actually replaced that spring bypass, put it back together. It was still shaking and popping. So I thought, there has got to be something else wrong with this heater. So I took it apart a third time. And I guess, as they say, third time's a charm, because I actually found the true problem with this heater. And that big wad of calcium was a clue. You'll see here in just a minute. Okay, we're going to take a look at the manifold now. Okay. Notice these tubes, two right in the middle are just white, filled with calcium, and one of them, the fourth one up there, or third one up from the bottom, see it's pretty white, was actually completely sealed off. So that wasn't allowing any of the water to come back through, and that's really what was causing the cracking and popping in this video, or on this particular heater. Each one of those tubes makes a loop, goes in the left side, comes back out the right. And since this one was clogged, that particular tube couldn't get the water out, so it was actually just boiling inside that center tube. I said that wrong. It goes in the right side and comes out the left, I believe it is. But either way, doesn't matter. Goes in one side and out the other. And because one end was plugged, it wasn't letting the water come back through the heater. So just something I just found out. But if you have one that's cracking and popping, this actually could be part of the problem too. So I got that cleaned out good. And if you had a pipe cleaner, like one of those metal ones they use on for copper tubing when you're putting together cleaning copper pipe, that one you can put on the end of your drill, that would have been a good idea, but I didn't have one in the truck. But as you can see, I guess you got the long part of the video. I'll show you the whole process. But at any rate, you can see that's what it was. Got that all cleaned out good. And we'll get this thing put back together here directly. Put it back together and see if that fixes it. Okay, so now we're just to the end. We're going to button it up and basically put it back together the same way we took it apart. Put all the bolts in it and tighten everything down, and we'll be good to go. Hey, if you found this helpful, learned something new, would like to see more videos like that, be sure and hit that like and subscribe button. And if I'm lucky, we'll see you in the next one. Thanks, guys. Have a great one. And God bless you.